YouTube.
Okay, so welcome back. This is the reassembly. I have fallen out of focus. I have changed the washer. Everything is going to get a light coat of hydraulic oil. When I put this back together, I took the automatic center punch and I hit the end thread twice so that it doesn't really want to go past that. If you apply a little bit of BFI, it certainly will, but it doesn't really want to. Now, on the cone pulley, at both of the dog lock centers, I filed, come on, which way is which? I filed just the tiniest little groove that you can find with a fingernail easily, but that's about it. Up and tighten. Apparently it's bug o'clock. Okay. So that's that, actually. First thing was that bearing or bushing with the oil galleries carved in opposite each other. This a coat, not because it's a wear part, just because it's an open to air-ish part. Excuse me, I'll be back. So, in the process of talking to my buddy, I realized that I forgot put the serpentine belt on before putting the spindle into place. of that. Let's go crud it up. That I had to soak it in carburetor cleaner. Of course, it is the size that I lost somewhere along the way. Oh, maybe not. Okay, so I'm gonna take this threaded bushing out to the drill press and drill in just through the threads. And I will be back shortly. I don't have a mill or flat bottom drills, but that should be the proper place to lock the bearing into position. There's our mark, and we'll be back again. I'm going to drill that one right through and through. New hole. Hopefully we will actually get oil going through to the spindle. I have seen a number of photographs and lathes.uk of Burns 4.5. That actually have a hex nut here in this position, but we have no idea as to whether those were aftermarket editions. Or what? Trying to find the Allen key for that.
Desperately need to make an Allen key holder.
All of the Allen keys that are needed for the lathe, except that one, because that's just a temporary fix, have flags on them similar to the hard flags used for the carbide tool bit holders. I thought I put a clear clear for actual duct tape. I thought I put a clear flag on that.
Hey, that is vraiment bizarre. The Allen key has run away.
The bar that the offset bar that the back gears ride on is marked 37. So last night, I guess I was a little overtired. I brought the Allen keys in my hand to show you how I had them flagged and to complain how I couldn't find the correct Allen key for this collar back here, and somehow managed to convince myself that I had put a clear tag on that Allen key and spent 20 minutes looking for the Allen key before I found one that fits, and complaining how I needed to get around to building something to hold all the Allen keys for the lathe, which I did do after. Just two pieces of scrap wood. This is a piece of wood from a pallet. This is a piece of wood that was off cut from a home cut board, just cut with a chainsaw. I cut it for the missing, or I drilled it for the missing clear tagged Allen key, and then this morning when I started putting them in, I noticed that the untagged key that I went and got to do that was exactly the same size as the yellow tagged key. So I have a spare spot for now. The finish on this is just the same hydraulic jack oil that I've been using as assembly oil. You missed me because of the dumbass forgetting to focus the camera back over here. You missed me putting this cap on, which is just two bolts screwed in, or two machine screws screwed in. A little bit of oil on the bearing before putting it on. So then I showed you that the offset shaft holds the back gears. I didn't even notice at the time, is smaller in the middle, and it is stamped with the number 37.
Okay, I see now. Can I see through here? That's another thing altogether. Yes, I can.
First thought it was 57.
Nope, definitely. It could be maybe. Nope, there's a serif on the bottom of the 3, so it cannot be an 8. And it comes up on this side, so it cannot be a 5. So, just a very light coat of oil. More thorough coat on the spot that does not turn, so it does not rust. Something tells me that's not right either.
And it wriggled and jiggled and tickled inside her.
Now, thinking about this overnight, I found two problems. One is that there is a gap here, which I think needs to be shimmed back that way somehow, which would mean a shim in here. But as far as I can tell, the shaft and this are all one piece. And how do you get a shim onto a shaft that is larger than the middle on both ends? Anybody have a solution, please let me know in the comments. The other is that there is a space you'd be able to see it there or not.
Nope.
Can you see the space here?
Yeah. Oh, now I can't. Very fuzzy.
Where's the ring?
There. Good.
You need to go back in further. This space here does not close up completely when you close this. So we need a shim in here, a very small, thin washer, and the reason we need both of those is because this gear,
uh-huh,
the smaller gear of the back gears, rubs on the lip of the cone pulley. looks like it might be the right size. That washer is a little bit too thick.
I've lost my toothpick again. Which I've lost two toothpicks this time. I brought two back to have a spare when I lost the first. Well, actually, the second one, but. Chipmunks are stealing my toothpicks. Are they nice?
Okay, so as I said in the previous video, you don't really need to see me assembling the counter shaft because that is particular to my machine. I have no idea what bits and pieces whoever did it cobbled together. Oh, the only other thing left to do is install the Well, I'm pretty sure they're not from Edmonton. Now these you kind of want to have pointing straight out at the operator. C.F. Tucker patented 033015. So, just put my hand in the fresh white paint, but that's okay. It stayed in the groove and wiped the rest off. Oh, it wants to ask Hartford, Connecticut.
I don't know how far back, so we've got 20 minutes. Again, says.
Okay, so that's it for now. And thanks for watching. With my love and leave this life behind.